Hi, and welcome to Lesson 1 of the Build Your Own E-Commerce Website tutorial series. My name is Rick Anderson, and I'll be your instructor throughout the entire series. The goal of this tutorial series is to show you how to create a fully functional e-commerce website using WordPress, Thesis, and WP EStore. This tutorial series assumes you have a hosting account with a domain name and WordPress installed on that domain. It also assumes that you have the Thesis theme installed and activated on that site. If this is not the case, please review the material in our Start Building Your Website Here tutorial series first. There is a bunch of information in that series that we will not be repeating here. In this lesson, we'll explore the organization of this e-commerce website and look at all of the building blocks we'll be using to create it. So in part one of the lesson, we'll take a brief tour of the demonstration website that I've created for this purpose. In part two of this lesson, we'll do an overview of the organization or of the information architecture of the new site. And in parts 3 through 6, we'll look closely at the 4 major components of our new site. Those components are sales, information, marketing, and user experience. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. In the first part of this lesson, we are going to view our desired outcome. So I want you to open your browser and go to www.thesisestore.com. Now, this is a website that I have created specifically for the purpose of demonstrating how to create such a website. And in the course of this tutorial series, we will learn step by step how to create every single element of this website. Now, on this website, we are selling a variety of products. We are selling physical books, ebooks, software, and video instruction. And the physical books obviously have to be mailed, and the ebooks, software, and video instruction all will have immediate secure download upon purchasing the product. Now, conceptually, we have 4 big elements to our site. The first is sales, and then information, marketing, and the user experience. And we'll be talking about all the subjects around this e-commerce site organized into these 4 areas. In terms of sales, we have our home page with a call to action, with a bunch of text describing why our product is great. We have a catalog that essentially serves as a department page that shows each of the different types of products that we sell. And then we have individual product type pages. So, for example, this product is books. Another product might be ebooks. And then finally, we have the individual detailed views of the books, where we have the full information about the product that we're selling. Next, we have our information component, and that includes our blog page, where we have informative articles that draw people to our site, and our customer support and about pages, which tell people about our policies and contact and support information. Next, we have our marketing. And the marketing portion of the site is focused on email marketing. So we have a variety of ways of capturing an email address. We have free downloads in exchange for email addresses. We have customer support requests in exchange for email addresses. And we collect the email address upon sales. And the purpose for collecting the email addresses in all of these cases is so that we can market additional products and services to the people who come to our site. And then finally, we have the user experience component of the site. And this includes things like our navigation system here, and the clarity of the information that's contained on the page, the ability for our customers to interact with our website via product reviews and customer support requests, and finally, the easy ability of our customers to make a purchase with a simple shopping cart that is clear and straightforward, and with a buy now option that will take people directly from the page to a place where they can purchase the product. Okay, that wraps up the first part of Lesson 1 of the Build Your Own E-commerce Website tutorial series. In the second part of this lesson, we'll take a look at how the site is organized in its information architecture.